Hello, welcome to Arvind Singh Academy, and we are going to discuss today a straight line. This is a second lecture on this topic. In very first lecture, we have reviewed what we have studied in class 10th. Now, this is time to start the topic of 11th, and that is starting from a straight line. So, let us start today straight line. What is a straight line and how to deal with this? So, a straight line. A straight line. Let me write this. Sorry. A straight line is in the topic. Let me write here. A straight line. Right? This is the topic. So in this topic, first of all, we have to learn about slope. And the general equation of a straight line is, let me write here, the general equation of a straight line, equation of a straight line is ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. This is the general equation of a straight line, where a, b, c are constant, where a, b, c are constant, right? If a is equal to 0, case first, few cases are there. Case first, when c is equal to 0, then equation ax plus by is equal to 0 is represent a straight line always passes through origin. Represent a straight line. A straight line always passes through origin. Always passes through origin. Through origin. Right? Origin. Ax plus by is equal to 0 is a straight line passes through origin. Right? Ax plus by. If there is no constant, because 0, 0 is satisfying this equation and therefore it will pass through origin. Now, case 2 is there. And what is that? When a is equal to 0, then equation reduces to, then equation a is equal to 0. See, if I put a is equal to 0, this will be by plus c is equal to 0. Represent y is equal to minus c by b, that is a constant. Y is equal to minus c by b, which is a constant. So y is equal to constant is a straight line. A straight line. Line parallel to x-axis. X-axis. So wherever y is equal to 0, it will represent a straight line parallel to x-axis. So say if this is, say this is x-axis. This one is x dash, this one is y, and that would be y dash. This is x axis, x dash, right? So a line parallel to y is equal to constant will be a line that will be parallel to x axis. Here, y is equal to some constant. Y is equal to some constant, say k, y is equal to some constant, depending upon constant. So y is equal to constant is a line parallel to, say, if it is passes through 3, then it can be said as y is equal to 3. This line is called y is equal to 3. This is origin. Similarly, y is equal to minus 2. If there is y is equal to minus 2, then that will be a line parallel to this direction. You know, so it will be also passing through this. Y is equal to some constant. Can be written like this. So, this will be a line, say this is a y is equal to 3 and that is y is equal to minus 1. I can write here y is equal to minus 1. Okay. Now, case third. Let us write here case third. Case third is there. When b is equal to 0, then what will happen? Then equation बी जीरो, देन इक्वेशन विल बी व्हाट, ए एक्स प्लस सी इज इक्वल टू जीरो, दिस इंप्लॉय ए एक्स इज इक्वल टू माइनस सी, एंड देयर फोर एक्स इज इक्वल टू माइनस सी बाई ए, दिस इज ऑल्सो कॉन्स्टेंट बिकॉज ए एंड सी आर कॉन्स्टेंट, सो सी बाई ए इज कॉन्स्टेंट, रिप्रेजेंट ए स्ट्रेट लाइन, ए लाइन पैरेलल टू रिप्रेजेंट ए स्ट्रेट लाइन पैरेलल टू x is equal to constant, then line parallel to y axis, parallel to y axis, right now. Similarly, there will be a line which is parallel to y axis. We can do that. There is a line, and this line is parallel to y axis. So we can do this. Here, this is x axis, this is x dash, this is y, and y dash. You know, this is x, x dash. So I can have a line which is a parallel to what? This is y axis. Say this is x is equal to 1. So x is equal to 1 is a constant which is represented a line parallel to what? Y axis. This is an origin. So you can do this. There is no problem. Now the thing is, line has either parallel to x axis and parallel to y axis, or whether it is passes through an origin, all these things comes with some angle. An angle is how we can say that lines are parallel or they are perpendicular, or what is the angle between them and how the line is inclined. So all these things are can be described by the word slope. So here I am going to introduce the word slope. Slope of line, slope. What is slope? So slope of a straight line is the tangent of, slope of a straight line, a straight line is the tangent of an angle, is the tangent of an angle made by line with positive direction of x axis, right now, with positive direction of x axis. If a line makes an angle theta with positive direction of x axis, if a line makes an angle theta with positive direction of x axis, with positive direction of x-axis, positive direction of x-axis, then tan theta is called slope of the line, and is represented as, is denoted by m, and therefore m is equal to tan theta. Here is a slope, we can write here this one is a line, say, and this is x axis, this is x dash, this one is y axis, y dash, x and x dash, right? So how to deal with this? This is x dash. If a line makes an angle theta, any line, say here, I have a line that makes an angle theta with positive direction of x axis. Say this is a line which makes with x axis, positive direction means anticlockwise, that is theta. So this tan theta is described as slope. Tan theta is positive direction means anti-clockwise direction. Positive direction means anti-clockwise direction. So tan theta is called slope. So depending upon the value of theta, slope can be positive or negative. Right now? So depending upon value of theta, therefore we can write depending on the value of theta, slope of a line can be positive or negative, right? Na? So if theta lies between 0 to 90, the slope of line is positive, right? And if theta is lies between 90 to 180 degree, the slope of line is negative, right? Na? So here we can take any one of the angle which is a smallest one, so it must be either between 0 to 180. So slope of line is this. Now if a line passes through two points x1 y1 and x2 y2, then slope of line is m, that is y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. This is the way in which you can calculate. Slope is x2 minus x1 comma y2 minus y1. How is that? Let me explain this, how this will come, right? So how is this? So if I write this is x-axis, say this is y-axis, okay? Now suppose there is a line on which there are two points. Line passing through two points, so definitely there will be two points, and line is passing through this, say line is this, and there are line passing through two points, say this is P x1 y1 and Q x2 y2. So say this is P x1 y1 and this is Q x2 y2. So here slope of the line is theta, right? Now, and if I can write, now I pause this video because of this making diagram. So I have this angle is theta, this angle is also theta, and we know tan theta is slope. So tan theta is given as, what will be tan theta in this triangle? Tan theta is y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1, and therefore slope is this one. So I hope you got it, why the slope is this, and the slope of line when passing through two points is equal to difference of y coordinate divided by difference of x coordinate. So you can do it easily, right? Now you can do it easily. So this you can keep in mind, that will be slope of a line. I hope you got it. Since slope is determined by an angle theta, so if two line makes equal angle, it means their value of tan theta will be equal, and therefore their slopes are equal, and two lines will be parallel. So lines will be parallel if their slopes are equal. Got it? So if a parallel lines has equal slopes, lines will be parallel if their slopes are equal. Their slopes are equal. That is, they mix same angle with positive direction of x-axis, right? Now then lines are parallel. So a parallel line can be described like this. This is a parallel line, say. Think about this. There is a line that can be described as parallel line. This is an x-axis, this is an y-axis, right? Now so x-axis and this one is y-axis. If lines are parallel, then their slopes must be same. So parallel lines have same slope. That is, they are making same angles, right? So if these two are parallel lines, say the lines are parallel, then they are making angles. These are corresponding angles, theta 1 and theta 2. Theta 1 and theta 2, these are the two angles made by two different lines. And since theta 1 is theta 2 is corresponding angle, corresponding angles, right now, theta 1 and theta 2 are corresponding angles. Let me write here. Okay, since theta 1 is equal to theta 2, corresponding angle, corresponding angles, right now, of two parallel lines, and therefore tan theta 1 is equal to tan theta 2, and tan theta 1 is called slope, so slope of lines are m1 is equal to m2. So these are the two different slopes of line, and slopes are equal, then lines are parallel. A line parallel to x-axis, any line parallel to x-axis, some corollaries are also there. Also, guess first, when a line is parallel to x-axis, line is parallel to, let me write the complete word, parallel. Line is parallel to x, parallel to x-axis, parallel to x-axis. So line makes an x-axis with two parallel lines, so theta will be 0 in that case. Theta is 0, and therefore tan 0 is also 0. Tan 0 is 0, that is slope of line is 0. So slope of line is 0 when line is parallel to x-axis. So if m is equal to 0, that is slope of line is 0, then it must be parallel to x-axis, right now? So a parallel line parallel to x-axis, slope is 0. So when slope is 0, then line must be parallel to x-axis, parallel to x-axis. Remember this. This is an important point. Case 2. I can write here case 2 as case 2. When a line is parallel to y-axis, line is parallel to y-axis, in that case theta equal to 90 degree, because y-axis makes an angle of 90 degree with x-axis, then tan 90 is not defined infinity, that can be written as 1 by 0, isn't it? So tan theta slope is 1 by 0, slope is infinite, then line is parallel to y-axis, and slope is infinity, it means there something must be in denominator 0. So then this is the condition, that when slope is infinity, we can write it and we can keep in memory. When slope of a line is infinity, is not defined, then line must be parallel to y-axis. So I hope you got this right now. So these are the few conceptual clarity about the line. Further we will discuss more about it, but now start some questions, and some questions will be helpful to understand this topic. So this is an exercise 10.1. We had some questions in the last lecture, and now this is question number 5, and starting with question number 5, first to 4 question has been discussed already in class 1, lecture 1. So starting from 5, find the slope of line. Question is, find the slope of a line which passes through the origin and the midpoints of the line segment and the midpoint of the line segment joining joining the points P 0 comma minus 4 and B 8 comma 0, right? So midpoint of P and B, these are the two points. So here A is the midpoint, say. If A be the solution, we can write here solution search. If A be the midpoint, A be the midpoint of point of if A be the midpoint of point of the line joining P 0 comma 4 and B 8 comma 0, then coordinate of A then coordinate of A is given by what? A will have coordinate x, I'm using midpoint formula, 0 plus 8 by 2 and 4 plus 0 by 2. That is, A has coordinate 4 comma 2. And since the line passes through origin and O, and therefore slope of line passes through origin and through origin 0 0 and A 4 2 is given by formula. What is the formula? M is equal to y2 minus y1. So 2 minus 0 upon 4 minus 0. That is 2 by 4, which is 1 by 2. And that will be answer. Using formula, what type formula I have used here? M is equal to y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. This is the formula which I have used here. Right now? So this is a question. Now, next question. Now the question number 6 is there, and in 6 question they say, without using Pythagoras theorem, Pythagoras theorem, prove that 4, 4 and 3, 5 and minus 1 are the vertices of right angle triangle. Right? So let us see the vertices of right angle triangle we have. So we can take on let A 4 comma 4, B 3 comma 5 and C minus 1 comma minus 1 are the vertices of triangle, right? Now so find the slope of AB. That is why we are going to look on slope of AB is what? Slope of AB is y2 minus y1, 5 minus 4 divided by 3 minus 4. That is 5 minus 4 is 1 upon minus 1 is minus 1. Slope of BC is what? BC is minus 1 minus 5 y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. That is minus 1 minus 3. So it will be minus 6 upon minus 4. That is 3 by 2. And slope of AC is nothing else but 4 minus minus 1, that is 4 plus 1, and 4 minus minus 1, that is 4 plus 1, which is 5 by 5, that is 1. So AB and AC, AB has slope minus 1 and BC has slope 1. This one is say is equal to M1 say, right? And this is an M2 say. This slope is called M3 say, right now. So here M1 into M3, product of slopes is minus 1 and therefore lines are parallel. Product of slopes is minus 1 and therefore lines are parallel. Since here M1 into M3 is equal to minus 1 and therefore line AB is perpendicular to line AC. AG is perpendicular to AC and therefore ABC is a right angle triangle. Right angle triangle. We will discuss this one, whether the product of slope is minus 1, the lines are perpendicular. Till now, you just memorize this and I'll discuss it, that why this line will be perpendicular when product of slopes is minus 1. That will be explained further, but for time being, you just remember this, that product of slopes of two lines are each minus 1, then line must be perpendicular to each other, right? So, we will use it, we will prove it also, how and why this will come. Now, the next question is question number 7. And the question number 7 is, find the slope of a line. Find the slope of a line. Slope of a line which makes an angle of 30 degree with positive direction of y-axis. Which makes an angle of 30 degree with positive direction of y-axis. Positive direction of y-axis. Direction of y-axis. Positive direction of y-axis. Measured anti-clockwise. Positive direction of y-axis means definitely measured anti-clockwise. Measured anti-clockwise. Clockwise. Of course, this is the positive direction. Right now, so how to deal with this? So here, you can analyze this. Say, this one is a line. Say, this one is a line. And we can have x-axis, x-dash, y-axis, and y-dash. This one is here. Right? So line makes positive direction of y-axis. So line must be like this, makes an angle of 30 degree. So 30 degree is an angle made by line, say this is what 30 degree. Okay. So positive direction of y-axis, it means the angle start from y-axis and anti-clockwise direction is this. Anti-clockwise, this direction is called anti-clockwise and this direction is called clockwise. You know, so this is clockwise, that one is anti-clockwise, clockwise and anti-clockwise. So this is 30 degree, right now, this one is 30 degree, line makes positive direction of x-axis with 30 degree. So if this is 30 degree, then what will be this angle? You can calculate it. What is the magnitude of this angle? So we can analyze this because this is 30 degree, so that will be also 30 degree. And because 30 degree, so this will be 60 degree. And because this will be 60 degree, so that must be 120 degree. So you can say that slope is always defined with angle made by positive direction, that is anti-clockwise direction with x-axis, that is 120, and tan 120 is what? This is more than 90 degrees, so slope is definitely negative, and slope is what? Slope is tan 120 degree, and tan 120 degree is minus root 3. So how to deal with this? So here, this actual slope of line is, slope is given by solution, is m, that is tan 120 degree. So tan 120 degree is tan 180 minus 60, that is minus tan 60 degree, right? And minus tan 60 degree is minus root 3. So slope is minus root 3. You got it? So direct method is that. Direct method. Method. Direct method is that. Direct method. If a line makes an angle phi, if a line makes an angle theta, theta with positive direction of y-axis, with positive direction, that is anti-clockwise direction, with positive direction of y-axis, positive direction of y-axis, then slope is equal to, slope is defined as minus 1 by tan theta. So that will be here minus 1 by tan 30 degree, and minus 1 by tan 30 is 1 by root 3, that is minus root 3. So this is a direct method in which you can calculate, and that was the conceptual method which I have discussed. Now there is a question, question number 8. Find the value of x. Find the value of x. Value of x for which points, for which points x comma minus 1, 2 comma 1 and 4 comma 5 are collinear, and 4 comma 5 are collinear. This can be proved by area of triangle as well. So if they are collinear, method 1, I am solving here, that if area of triangle is 0, then there will be, if points are collinear, points A x comma minus 1, B 2 comma 1 and C 4 comma 5 are collinear, then area of triangle must be equal to 0, collinear. Then area of triangle must be 0. Area of triangle ABC must be equal to 0. Now find area of triangle. Area of triangle is therefore, area of triangle ABC is what? 1 by 2 modulus of x into y2 minus y3, 1 minus 5 plus x2, y3 minus y1, 5 plus minus minus 1, that is 6, plus x3, 4 into what? 4 into, this is x3, 4 into minus 1, minus 1, that must be equal to 0. So 0 is equal to 1 by 2, that will be here minus 4x, and 5 plus 1, 6 to 12, and this is minus 2 multiplied by 4 is minus 8, that is 0. This employee, this 2 will multiply this at 0, this will be minus 4x plus 4 is equal to 0, and that will be 4x is equal to 4 and x is equal to 1. That will be the answer. So I hope you got it. So one value of x is 1. Now there is another method in which you can deal with this question, that is method 2, that if lines are collinear, their slopes are equal. So if A, B, C are collinear means lies on the same line, say there is A, there is B, there is C. So slope of AB and slope of BC are same, slope of BC and slope of AC are same, slope of AB and slope of AC are same. So they must be, as their slopes are same, whether the line, they are collinear, they lie on the same line, then their slopes must be same. If lines is like this, here these are the three points, say this is A, this is B, this is C. So slopes of any of these two points are same. So now considering this, because we have to calculate the value of x, so slope of AB must be equal to slope of BC, isn't it? And slope of line joining two points can be obtained by y2 minus y1. Slope is what? What we have learned? Y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1 is the slope. That you know. This is the formula. So we can use it here, slope of line joining AB. AB is what? So that can be 1 minus minus 1. That is 1 minus minus 1 is 1 plus 1 upon 2 minus x. So 1 plus 1 upon 2 minus x. This is the slope of AB. And slope of BC is also 5 minus 1 upon, what is that? 4 minus 2. 4 minus 2. So we can write 4 minus 2. I hope you got it. This means 2 upon 2 minus x is equal to 5 minus 1 is 4 and 4 divided by 2. 2 to ja 4. So this will be 2, 2 cancels also. So this means 2 minus x is equal to 1. And hence 2 minus x is equal to 1 this side, 1 left. So here x is equal to, therefore x is equal to, this one will come this side, 2 minus 1 is 1. And that is the answer of this question. So even with the second method you can also do. So you have seen here that a number of methods are there in which one can solve the questions. And this is very interesting. Definitely you will be able to enjoy this topic. This is the easiest chapter so far in mathematics. So but for competitive level there will be a something big you have to think. But for school examination, this is very, very interesting topic in which you can learn many things from your everyday life. So thank you very much for watching this. And if you haven't subscribed this channel, don't forget to subscribe this channel and press bell icon so that you will get notification as soon as I post a video. So thank you. Thank you very much. God bless.